Today in the liturgy, we celebrate the martyrs of Japan. Actually, there were several martyrs, and this illustration there shows how St. Paul Miki, with 26 other martyrs of Japan, went to their death. And in a way, that reflects on the saga of the mission of the Church in Japan. Paul Miki was a Jesuit scholastic in theology, almost about to be ordained before he was also led to death. But together with him were also St. James Kisai, another Jesuit lay brother, and also St. John de Gordo, also a catechist who took his first vows before being executed. But the story of Paul Miki starts with Francis Xavier in 1549, when Francis Xavier first landed in Japan and started the mission that eventually, according to estimates, reached almost 200,000 Catholics. But in 1587, the Shogun Hideyoshi banned the missionaries out of fear that the colonial masters at that time, the Spaniards, were also out to conquer Japan. And it was also due to some rumors from some other merchants, from foreigners, who were sort of giving the suspicion that the Europeans were out to conquer Japan. But despite the ban in 1587, for the next 10 years and more, actually, many Christians remain, including the priests. In fact, by the time in 1587, there were already 113 Jesuits. In 1596, Paul Miki, also with Saint Pedro Bautista, a Franciscan, were imprisoned together with these other, you know, 26 martyrs. And they were forced to march from Kyoto to Nagasaki, about 800 kilometers, during winter time, undergoing the hardships of that forced march. Together with them were 6 Franciscans and 17 Japanese lay men and women, including 2 teenagers. And they were eventually crucified, led to death on Martyr's Hill in Nagasaki in 1597. It is good to keep in mind that 1597 was also the year when the first chapel was built here in Butuan on the island of Mindanao by 2 Jesuit missionaries who eventually had to return to Cebu. But the real evangelization that took place with the Augustinian Recollectors in 1622, and that is why last year the Archdiocese here also celebrated the 400th anniversary of Christianity in Mindanao. Paul Miki himself was recorded because there were other bystanders who listened to his final sermon, you might say. And I quote, "As Christ, to help you become happy, I obey Christ. After Christ's example, I forgive my persecutor. story of St. Paul Miki, who died at the age of 35. Together with him was activist St. Pedro Bautista, who is better known here in the Philippines because he worked in the Philippines for 9 years. Before coming to the Philippines, he was actually a noted preacher in Toledo. He taught philosophy for 3 years, and he was also an established musician. He spent 3 years in Mexico before coming to the islands. And he is credited with being the founder or co-founder of towns spanning from Bulacan to Camarines, to the Bicol region, Moron. In Camarines, Tagsawa, Limnumanan, Bukit, in Laguna, Tanay, Baras, Pakil, in Bulacan, Pol. In 1590, he also established San Francisco del Monte, which still exists today in Quezon City. And there one can still find a cave where he used to spend hours in meditation. And San Francisco del Monte today, as before, has also become a retreat center for missionaries going to Japan and other places. San Pedro Bautista also founded the Los Baños Hot Springs, and he was also known to have defended the natives against the tribute, giving the full tribute when the encomendero was not yet giving the full services to the natives. In 1592, he was asked to be the Spanish envoy to the Shogun Hideyoshi. And for a while, he was successful. Hideyoshi even allowed him to establish a home or a center in Japan. But by 1597, with the banning of all Christian missionaries, he too was part of the 26 martyrs that were here on the hill in Nagasaki, now called Martyrs Hill. So this is the story of two missionaries that one is really a native Japanese priest, the other a missionary, but together with the other lay people, they were martyred in 1597. There is a third story of Blessed Justo Takayama, who died in 1615. He was actually a daimyo and a shogun. One epithet given to him was he was the Jesuit samurai, because despite his stature, he did not accept the banning of all Christians by Hideyoshi, but instead he accepted to go on exile, to forego all his status and properties, and went to Manila in 1614, arriving on December 11, staying at the Jesuit house. But by February 3 or 5, the day that we commemorate also in 1615, he died of illness. Actually, he was buried in the Jesuit church, and his process was delayed for a long time, perhaps also due to the closure of Japan itself. But he was beatified only in 2017, when Pope Francis also agreed that his death should also be considered the death of a martyr, because he underwent the hardships of the voyage. He had to forego all his privileges as a daimyo, and in a sense, he died of sickness after the arduous voyage. There is a statue to Justo Takayama in Plaza Dilao in Papo. It may have been removed for a while because of the construction of the skyway, but it was there prominently because Papo was also the place of refuge of other Japanese Christians exiled from Japan. In Osaka Cathedral today, where I was able to visit just before the pandemic, there is a large icon of Blessed Justo Takayama, and in a sense, his process for canonization is still ongoing. But this is really not the end of the story of the martyrs of Japan. In 1622, again, the day when we celebrated the coming of the Recollectors to Mindanao for the first time, there were also 52 other martyrs, and included was Beato Sebastian Kimura, another Jesuit, who was the first Japanese priest to be ordained. Together with him was also Carlos Spinola, another Jesuit. And it is good to reflect that at that time already, there were native priests in Japan, whereas in the Philippines, there was still a struggle among the missionaries whether to allow the education of Filipinos to the priesthood. And it was only in later centuries that we had the first Filipino priest. But here in Japan, as early as you might say the late 16th century, you already had some Japanese seminarians, and by the beginning of the 17th century, you had the first Japanese priest in the person of Beato Sebastian Kimura, who was also beheaded and actually burned to death in 1622. So we pray for the church in Japan today. It is also built on the blood of martyrs. And in many ways, the church there now enjoys complete freedom of religion, but it is still a challenge to share the good news of the gospel with the modern-day Japanese citizens today. But in a sense, the blood of martyrs is again